Well, it is always an honor to have the Oakland A's Hall of Famer, one of the greatest players in A's history, to be on with us, A's Cast Live, on a day like this where we're remembering one of his heroes and the great Dave Stewart back in town. He'll be doing A's pre and post game live. And Dave, I just think about you as a kid growing up in Oakland, what Vida Blue must have meant to you as a kid.
You know, I was real, real fortunate. The first major meeting was Reggie Jackson, and I met Reggie in 68. And knowing Reggie and getting to know Reggie, it gave me access to a lot of the players with the Oakland A's teams back then. And then having the opportunity to meet Vida, was magical for me. You know, I'd already adopted Juan Marichal and Bob Gibson as guys that I wanted to be like if I had an opportunity to pitch at the major league level. And then, you know, watching Vida Blue and Blue Moon Odom, you know, and Catfish even, it was even more of an impression on me. And then having an opportunity to talk with Vida, you know, at 19 years old and me being 12 years old, you know, I didn't see him that much as, you know, a major league player. I looked at him more as one of the guys that I played in the street with when I was playing baseball with my brother. And, you know, I don't know if I fault my brother to that or I give gratitude to him, because when I met Vida, I felt like I was just talking to one of the kids that I play with.
That's kind of crazy. I didn't think about that. Like, here he is. He's becoming the MVP and the Cy Young Award winner, and he actually isn't that much older than you.
It's the truth. I mean, my brother is 5 years older than me, and he brought me everywhere that he went. I played baseball against all of his friends, and they were all older. And so, I mean, think about it. Vida was 19 years old when he showed up in the big leagues. And literally, man, a couple years older than my brother. So, you know, he could have been playing in the street with us.
That is just, that's awesome. And I just think for you, seeing an African-American young pitcher just not be a good pitcher, but he becomes a star. Like, I've been trying to tell everybody, we're just not talking Sports Illustrated, Baseball Digest back then. We're talking Time Magazine. We're talking Newsweek. We're talking late night talk shows. Vida Blue became an American sports star, and he's doing it right in front of you.
And he was. And it became apparent, you know, when Vida finally got the opportunity to have impact on this team, he took the bull by the horns. You know, he had a tremendous 71 season. And that's a document that we all know what he did that year. But it wasn't just that year. He continued to do it. And that 71 season, when you really look at the numbers, it was a very dominant year. Very, very dominant year.
I know a guy who was a mentor to you, taught you the old forkball. You think about the great Sandy Koufax. You know, there haven't been, especially during that time, you hadn't seen that many left-handers who could get up on the mound, bring it high 90s, if not 100 miles an hour. We didn't have the gun then. But just talk about, you know, what he was doing, that kind of just talent. You didn't see that very often in our game.
No, you didn't. It was very, very, very uncommon to see somebody with that kind of stuff take the mound and be as dominant as he was. I mean, he was absolutely unbelievable at that time. The things he was doing, throwing in the high 90s, dominating very good major league hitters. Just unbelievable the job that he did in that period of time.
And you think about his stardom, but what a great person, Vida Blue, everybody that got to know him, the way he treated all of us, even though he was the superstar, three-time champion, you know, the all-star games, the awards. Vida treated everybody the same. He was just so kind.
Vida was one of the, you know, Vida was from Louisiana, and my folks are from Louisiana, and Vida didn't have any traits that were very different from my parents. They didn't know any strangers. everybody was family, and that's how Vida treated people.
Well, I say this from this goes way back, like into the Fox Sports days, into the Comcast Sportsnet. Like, I would see Vida in there, and he's working with all these young people. They really don't kind of like, you know, you think about your great career. You might work with a young person, and they don't know your entire history. Vida never big leagued anybody, even if they didn't know all the greatness about him. He worked with them in television there in the same studios you're in now. Never big leagued anybody.
No, that's just not in his DNA. Vida was good to anybody that crossed his path. He was just an unbelievable human being. You won't meet very many people like Vida Blue. And that's, you know, that's the legacy that he's left behind. You know, if you hear it from one person, right at this moment, you're hearing it from me. But if you talk to someone separate of me, they'll say the exact same thing about Vida. And you know what that means? That means he was consistent. He was consistent in who he was every day and how he treated people every day.
I know you got to do pregame, so we'll let you go. Let's just end on this. I know Vida Blue would be very proud of you and what you're doing with Nashville. And this is going to be historic in our game. Just how is everything going with your pursuit to get a Major League Baseball team?
You know, unfortunately, with all the news of the A's, it's really accelerated the things that are happening in Nashville. And, you know, we've been preparing for this for the last 4 years, and we know that there's still a pretty good road to go before we can actually put a team on the field. But, you know, with the A's, making the decision that they made, like I said, I mean that sincerely, unfortunately, because I could never picture Oakland not having a major league franchise. And that's an unfortunate situation, but that accelerates it. And then we're hoping that Tampa can figure out what they're going to do by the end of the year. And then that puts the commissioner in a situation that he can talk to the owners about two-team expansion.
Well, I always thank you for your time. It means so much. And I'll be in with you on Thursday and Friday on A's pre- and post-game live.
Looking forward to seeing you, man, and working with you, as you always know, Tony.
Take care, buddy.
Take care.